Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel with another video. This time the bike I'm gonna be reviewing is nothing short of a legend. Yes, you guys heard it right, it's the Jawa. And in today's video I'm gonna introduce you all to the new Jawa 42, which is one of the two bikes that Jawa had launched last year. It's a brand that needs no introduction at all. It's been there, conquered our roads and hearts with its two-stroke engine, but sadly the company had to phase out and shut down because of strict emission norms back in the early 1990s. But the legend is making his way back, all thanks to Anand Mahindra and Mr. Anupam Tereja. And classic legend planned for the brand revival of Jawa, the main challenge they faced was to retain and recreate that cult retro design that the original Jawa had, for which it had a huge impact on the masses at that time. The main hurdle of the R&D team was to upgrade the two-stroke engine to the four-stroke engine one without changing the original retro design that Jawa had. For this, they have used Mahindra Mojo's engine architecture as a reference, extensively tuned the engine to make it what sounds like a modern-day Jawa. They did a great job with it and successfully recreated that same magic.
Classic Legend was successful in retaining the retro design starting from the headlamp to the tail lamp. All starts from the spoke wheels at the front and rear. The round headlight unit, which is a halogen one with offset speedometer. Then there is a teardrop shaped classic fuel tank with matching side panels. Overall, the bike looks really low with low seat height, which is good and flat but not as comfy as it has a thin layer of foam. At the rear, they shaped it with a round mudguard with twin gas charged shock absorbers. Talking about the engine design, they used chrome finish, which is standalone design and a fine piece of art. The cylinder head with two port exhaust, which is reminiscent of old Jawa. Talking about the engine and gearbox, Jawa comes with a single cylinder DHO seal, fuel injected, liquid cooled 293cc engine, which produces 27 HP of power and 28 Nm torque. The engine is a BS6 variant. Its bore is 76 mm and stroke is 65 mm. It's got a 6-speed gearbox, which is of constant mesh. Jawa 42 has a wide handlebar, and the quality of switchgears and grips are really good. And there is even a Jawa emblem depicted on the grips. Talking about the instrument console, it's a minimal design with offset speedometer. You got a speedometer, odometer, and fuel gauge. Talking about the brakes and tires, Jawa 42 comes with a 280 mm disc up and 150 mm drum brakes at the back. The bike is equipped with a single channel ABS. The front tire is 90 by 90, 18 inch front, and rear tire is 120 by 80, 17 inch spoke wheels. Coming to the suspension, it has got a telescopic hydraulic forks up front and a twin shock at the rear. The frame is of double cradle frame. The seat height of Jawa 42 is 765 mm and the wheelbase is 1369 mm. The overall weight of this bike is 170 kgs and the fuel tank capacity is 14 liters.
Jawa 42 comes in 6 color variant, which is Nebula Blue, Comet Red, Starlight Blue, Lumos Lime, Halley's Tail and Galactic Green.
Overall, the seat height and the bike feels low, and you may seem that the gap is low in the underside, but you don't need to worry. It's enough for our kind of roads. It won't hit any bumps or anything. It is enough for our road conditions, but overall the bike feels low. It is appealing.
So guys, all done with the spec review. Now I'm gonna ride it, and okay, so first of all let me get onto the bike.
Yeah. Riding posture is upright because of this wide and upright handlebar, and the foot pegs are placed centrally, that you have a straight 90 degree posture, which is good. And the next thing you feel is the seat may seems comfy, but this seat is not that comfortable because it's got a thin layer of foam, which is not good for, you know, long ride, and it will make you uncomfortable after 20 or 30 kilometer ride, because I can feel it, it's a bit stiff. So let me just quickly start this bike and start our ride review. Okay, here we go. So we have to put the clutch in to press the ignition. start. Wow! The acceleration in the first and second gear is hard. That means that it kind of have a sport bike kind of feel in first and second gear. It will accelerate quickly to 60 km per hour in second gear itself. See, I just hit 60 in second gear. So this bike has got a pretty quick mid-range. But the thing is that it doesn't have a top end. I mean, it will hit the rear limiter earlier in the rev range because of its speed-tuned kind of nature. But overall, the bike is stiff on the riding side because the suspension is kind of stiff on the front and back end. But it's plushy. So let me just stick around traffic and let's check the handling first. Quick and easy because of the wide handlebar, you kind of won't feel the weight of this bike, and when you turn the bike you can apply more leverage, and that will aid you to flick around through traffic quickly and easy. See, the acceleration is pretty quick, like a sport bike. And there is another question. Will this bike heat up in traffic situations? Yes, it will heat up. It's a liquid cool bike, so eventually it will heat up and throw hot air into your legs. But it's common and okay for a liquid cool engine. You can't complain about it because things are like that only. I mean, I'm kind of enjoying it riding this Jawa bike in city traffic. I mean, heavy city traffic. See, you can pull it up to 20 plus kilometer per hour in first gear itself. Currently I am riding at second gear itself. And gears are smooth and okay. I tend to get into force neutral sometime, but I would say overall the gearing is pretty precise. Kind of get in the front, the disc brake is good and enough for stopping 170 kg bike. In the back you got a drum brake which is okay, and it kind of gives you enough feedback. I would say enough, but not okay for 300 cc bike. The front end gives you immense feedback, and the biking power is there, and ABS is also there, single channel ABS, which fits in easily without heavy interference. And easily accelerate through the traffic and get through it. Just the power from the low end and mid range is much on the higher side. I mean, I'm kind of enjoying this. See, I'm just quickly gonna off take this. Front brake, I'm pushing hard the front brake itself, but it's tend to, bite pretty well and with enough feedback to stop this bike. And head-to-head competitor for this segment is with Bullet 350. But Jawa is on another level. It's got the power, it's got the torque, it's got the equipment. I mean, I would say it's a modern retro bike. This Jawa is great handling bike. All thanks to the wide handlebar, I would say. Okay, so let me just stop here for a moment. And in the speedo, you got a fuel gauge, an odometer, a trip meter, ABS light indicator, a neutral, and a cool looking Jawa emblem on the middle, which will light up when you switch on, turn on the ignition. The engine is refined and smooth. I'm not getting any kind of knocking or vibration. I'm in third gear right now and hitting around 40 kmph, and there is not a lot of vibration. So overall, it's a great bike. There is no amount of vibration at all. The mirror is, kind of stable. So I'm not getting any kind of vibration. Like it and do subscribe to my channel if you guys like my videos, and there will be a separate top speed run coming up on my channel of Jawa 42. So
thanks for watching guys, please do subscribe to my channel.